Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture series on PLC programming. In today's video, I'll be explaining example number 12, which is bearing lubrication program. This is a very unique program for that matter. The reason is you'll be using on delay timer, off delay timer, retentive timer, and the concept of cascading timers, all of them in one particular program. And that is why I've chosen this. It's very simple and straightforward. First, let us look at the question, try to understand the requirement. And from there, we can start with the ladder diagram. So the question is as follows. You can read it, but I'll be explaining the summary in the shortest possible way so that you'll be understanding what is the requirement. So there is an operator who will press the switch to turn on the machine. So the machine is basically a motor over here. Before that, the motor should be supplied by oil by the pump for 10 seconds. So the pump starts once the switch is pressed, and consequently for 10 seconds the pump keeps pumping oil to the motor, and once 10 seconds gets over, the motor starts. So once the motor is started, what happens? The motor should still continue to get the oil from the pump, so the pump also should be on and the motor also should be on in this case. When the operator turns switch off, for some reasons maybe, the oil should still be supplied by the pump for 15 seconds. So this is where I'll be using off delay timer, and I'll explain that in the ladder diagram, but just be aware that this is required. So they themselves have mentioned that a retentive timer is required to track the overall time of the pump. So it's pretty straightforward that we have to use a retentive timer. So this is used in order to keep the track of the overall time. So if the process is taking place for 3 hours, for example, by 2 hours you are actually turning it off, the switch off, and you again turn it on, the retentive timer continues from 2 hours and keeps the track, and that is why the accumulated value keeps storing the values, and that is according to the working of retentive timer, and it keeps counting the values from 2 hours even if the process is stopped and started. And that is why we'll be using retentive timer in this process. And after 3 hours, what should be done? The filter and oil needs to be changed. So there'll be a specific amount of oil required for 3 hours, and that is what we'll be supplying. After 3 hours, the filter needs to be changed, and this is a mechanical process that needs to be taken care of, and that needs to be automated. And that is why we will be going for this type of a ladder diagram logic that will actually solve the requirements basically. Reset button is provided to reset the process after the filter and oil have been changed. So I hope the question is clear. Let us look at the ladder diagram. So now let us go case by case whether it is satisfying all our condition according to the problem statement. So the operator will actually press the push button switch over here. The switch starts and the run gets energized, and the on delay timer and off delay timer will be energized simultaneously. According to the operation of on delay timer, enable bit will go high and the done bit will not go high instantly, whereas off delay timer, enable and done bit will go high instantly, and that is why it is indicated in green over here. So the green ones basically means that they are energized, and the red one means they are de-energized. Now since off delay timer T41 done bit is used over here, the address is used over here, so since this is high, this will also be high, and as a result the run gets energized, the pump will also go high and get started. What are we able to achieve? Once the switch is pressed, the pump is started. So this is one important observation. All of these process takes place instantly, but I'm explaining case by case. So now the pump is started. The same address is used over here. Since this is going high, this will also go high. The retentive timer also will be started. So the retentive timer enable bit also gets high according to the working of retentive timer. So what is happening? Once you press the switch, the pump is turned on, the retentive timer and on delay timer starts counting the values. So the on delay timer counts the values in seconds for 10 seconds in this particular fashion. But one thing that I have not shown here is the retentive timer also keeps counting the second values. So this is 3 hours, that is 10,800. So that basically means 3 hours. So it keeps counting the values. But with respect to on delay timer, after 10 seconds is being counted, what happens? The done bit goes high. So since the done bit here goes high, T40 done bit is used here. The same address is used over here. Hence this goes high instantly, and consequently the motor starts rotating. That means what are we able to achieve till now? Once you press the switch, the pump was turned on, and for 10 seconds it waited and it kept on supplying oil to the motor, and after 10 seconds the motor started rotating, and now according to the requirement, the motor is running, the pump is still on and supplying oil. So initial condition of our program is met. Now I'll be turning the switch off in this particular fashion. What happens? The rung gets de-energized because this is open circuit over here. If this is open circuit, no current flows through this path. As a result, on delay timer will be de-energized. Enable and done bit will go high instant, will go low instantly according to the working of on delay timer. And off delay timer also will be de-energized because the same contact is taken at this point. And as a result, according to the working of off delay timer, the enable will go low. But once on delay timer was initially energized and then de-energized, the off delay timer starts counting its delay values. But before that, if you carefully observe, T40 done bit went low, isn't it? So T40 done bit went low and same contact is used here. So as a result, this also goes low and the motor stops rotating. So once the motor stops rotating, so once you press the switch, the motor stopped rotating and now the time delay starts counting. So it keeps counting up to 15 seconds. The pump keeps supplying oil for 15 seconds. That is according to the problem statement. And we are able to achieve this, isn't it? After 15 seconds, the done bit goes simulated value is equal to preset value. As a result, it goes slow. So once the done bit goes low here, T41 done bit is used over here. As a result, the pump also stops. So we are able to achieve this condition, isn't it? So one thing that needs to be noted here is now the pump is going low. This also gets de-energized because same pump is used over here, the address. As a result, the retentive timer also turns off. So the retentive timer might have some value through the process, maybe 1 hour it has counted. And in 1 hour when it was running, we pressed the switch and the entire process came to a halt and it counted some value. And that will be stored in the flash memory. Once you again start the process by pressing the switch, this retentive timer keeps counting the value from 1 hour where the process was previously left and keeps continuing. After 3 hours, what happens? This done bit goes high. And consequently, this gets energized and the pilot light turns on to indicate that we have to manually make the changes to change the oil and the filter. So that is how we will be able to understand the operation of these type of ladder diagram. I hope this concept is clear. Try to understand this and analyze this on your own. In case you have any question, feel free to reach out by typing in your questions in the comment section below. If you like this video, please do like it, share it and subscribe to our channel for regular updates. Thank you.